Really weird not being able to equip stuff on Sweeper and Strewn at the same time.
Yeah. I kind of hated that. I eventually just decided, eh, my carrier is not that helpful. I'm just going to accept that it's not going to be as good and give it the dump mods.
It's just a little awkward because they show up on the screen anyway, and I don't think there's any indication you can't use them until you manually place them and says nope, and you do that like 3 times and realize that all things you're trying to put on it are not options anyway.
So Chad has a good point. If you progress through the planets rather than letting the quest jump you around, the hacking progression is rather smooth. They're right, because we went from Venus to Jupiter, and if we had actually done like the Earth and Mars spy missions, it would have actually been... would have made sense.
Is there like a clear... Does the game have a clear progression to it, though?
Yeah, we just kind of skipped around and skipped past it because...
Because you guys don't like doing spy missions?
To be fair, can you imagine Birdcatcher getting through
asking,
that on
like,
the first
try? The only explanation I really have is I think we've just been skipping every spy mission in the game so far.
I didn't really like them until I had practice, and then some of my fans were like, hey, let's go farm for this rare thing, and I'm like, alright. And I effectively trial by fire.
There are 3 data vaults and 3 codices. Proceed with caution. If Corpus Security destroy even one of these fragments, this mission will be a failure.
It has been amusing just how totally mindless every hacking has been up till now.
Oh yeah.
And then the game just stomped me.
Sometimes you kind of need that to happen, though. If everything was easy, what would be the point?
No, but just you ramp things, usually.
Oh, yeah. Oh, okay, that's just the enemy.
I'll turn that off. I'm already doing it.
Beatcha.
I literally couldn't tell if you beat me or not, honestly. Alarms reset. Your treasure belongs to me! Can you actually go noise, go loud through the entire mission and it not matter until you get inside the actual location of the purge?
Yep.
Huh. That's different.
Yeah.
I suppose that's one definition of stealth.
Go the right way? Yeah. Generally, even if enemies notice you, it's not so bad.
Failure.
Oh no, what have you done?
Don't worry about it.
Wander, we trusted you.
I've got like 40 ciphers. Alright, screw it.
Data integrity verified. Retrieval was successful.
Yeah, I bought the 10 pack of ciphers because I had a lot of money, and so I've just producing ciphers for fun. And
I am noticing that you you definitely consistently knock the helmets off these guys with this weapon.
Oh yeah. Alright. Let's see. By the way, if you want, I can also, like, come and just hang out near you. So if things do go south, I can shoot people. You're probably fine,
the
though.
Hell? Oh. There we go. Slightly
down,
thrown up by a layout
below.
Of something.
There we go.
Ooh! There's the stealth kill. Oh look, it's the same room. Are we in the same level?
There's a lot of repeated stealth rooms. I'm not gonna sugarcoat it. They're going to feel very familiar by the 5th run. Huh. I once got the,
well, I mean, I figured we were just literally doing the same mission, aren't we?
No, it randomizes. It randomizes everything, every time.
Weird.
Actually not always. The defense mission that we did.
It never really feels that different.
It doesn't. Like, the defense mission we did, first tonight, that is always the same layout. But a lot of the other ones tend to randomize just a little bit.
Yeah, because that entire level was just a big circle anyway, of just guys running into a room to attack a thing.
Most defense missions and intercept missions will use the same tile set over and over again.
Only so much variance to add to that one.
Oh yeah.
Huh. Trigger the alarms now, and they will start destroying the data.
Okay, good. This is the easy one. accidentally slipped.
Keep getting
my
to
ass.
Pick up loot. I mean, feel good.
Outside the level.
All right, moment of interest. How do I use the
if
cipher if I need it?
It will say use cipher directly underneath the like little hacking section. It's pretty damn hard to miss.
I beat it.
Okay.
That wasn't such a big deal. There was just no warning the first time was the rough thing.
I messed up. Eh, whatever.
What have you done? Oh my god, there's a second one. Shit.
There we go. You got it. The data
is still intact. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. No! Shit. I'll be fine. Lose this data and the mission will be I was short by like a second.
If it's also your last one, you can just use the cipher. Should be pretty easy.
Ah. Oh, I don't have any ciphers, apparently.
You forgot to pick it up.
Oh. Well, shit.
You gotta claim it. Well...
Ah, we got it. It's fine.
Okay.
It's nice. It's fine. Everything's fine. Don't worry about it.
Oh! Since we triggered all of the alarms, it's now a kill everyone mission.
Ooh. Well, the good news is we got all the data. Now let's just do some murders. Only like 20 anyway.
Oh yeah, it's super easy. There are not a whole lot of enemies spawning in these missions.
There we go. Clear.
Yeah, what this game used to do is it would. Oh, that's not so great.
What?
It's an enemy type called a Bursa. It's a tank. It's just a straight up tank.
Well, let's go use our anti-armor missiles. Also known as our brains, Wander.
Are you like a children Saturday morning cartoon?
Yes. Now that we got that cleared out. Oh, that guy's arm is off. Let's try to put him back together, kids.
Yeah, you can...
This didn't go anywhere at all.
You can cleave people pretty hard. Oh, I just took out one of those flying osprey things. I took out the main body, but it left its wings behind, so the body just flies away. And the wings are just like, eh, we're just gonna drop here. Why not? Who cares?
Nope. Exactly, I have a plan on where I'm going, but I'll figure it out. Oop, there we go. The important thing is that we're having fun! And maybe a few murders. It'll be fine.
Maybe a few many murders.
So when I use my speed boost, do you get a speed boost?
Only if I'm nearby.
Oh.
However, it's got a fairly large range. And if you do that, then suddenly I'm going...
Can't go that way.
Very fast. I'll bring my, if we ever have to do, like,
a... I found a one-way vent.
If we have to do another capture mission, I'll bring my Volt along. And I'll show you what, like, Get It Out 1 can do speed-wise. It gets pretty uncomfortable.
I just like the idea that you'd be like, I'm feeling fast today, Keith must be nearby.
It's, I've screwed up, people pretty bad using the speed boost, actually. Like
you start glowing like Sting.
Yeah, so the thing is, you can go so fast you can wedge yourself in the level architecture, and it's fairly frequent.
That feels like we should use some bug testing.
It's, I don't know, I kind of enjoy it. I've been stuck inside of a rotating door thing, because why not?
Oh, everything's dead. Well,
yeah.
Did you have fun fighting the tank?
Yeah. It was like 7 arrows. Isn't so bad.
Whatever that guy looks like. Oh, that's a laser. Shame on you, security camera. Oh, there goes that counter. Then you're trying to open loot, because I'm like, it's probably worth it, right? I don't know.
I don't really bother with loot. Usually there's a better farming
there's
place
loot,
than...
But they're everywhere, Wander. There's loot boxes everywhere.
Yeah. So there
How
are specific
can you not?
Missions. Yeah. Man, I got like 200,000 of certain things. And like the rare resources, there's better stuff too. Usually if you want to get a rare resource, you go fight a boss a bunch. And that'll do it.
This zone just keeps going.
It
makes
yeah,
you wonder why they
bothered
putting them there then if they're not used, if they're not worth grabbing.
They are, but it's kind of one of those where it's like technically by the time you get through all the quests, yeah, you're gonna have more resources. But otherwise you could just go load up a specific mission here or there and get more faster. But that only usually works if you've got like a ferry to carry you around or something like that. My stream announcement.
Definitely amusing looking at my own preview of my stream and just see it turn into a giant block of mosaic, like blocky mosaic. But then
whenever
the moment I stop moving,
it
turns perfect.
Yes.
Likely rusted into dust by now.
Ordo, did you say something about a machine?
Ordis's name is Ordis.
Yeah. Listen, that first codex is in the Derelict. I pulled it from some sort of machine.
I wonder if we load the complete set of arcane codices back into that machine, would the code still execute?
We're about to find out. Tenno, get ready to go into the void.
We're going into the Orcan Derelict, yay.
Well, I can use pressure point now. That's my 120% bonus damage.
Oh, yeah.
Nice. That'll help.
Fortunately,
I can't equip anything else with it right now, because it's level 9, or it's requirement 9 at least. The hazard of upgrading your mods. A weird quirk I found? This was a few missions ago now, but I did the power slide, and then I fired a lightning bolt, and then I just kept power sliding afterwards as if I had started over. Like, I lightning-propelled sliding that just kept going.
Huh.
I guess Bird's been getting complaints about Andrew saying racist shit on the podcast.
Does this actually surprise you that much?
Nah, it's one of those things that just doesn't faze me anymore.
It fazes me a little bit. Just because.
I think you probably picked up on the pattern a little bit, though, where he just, like, he picks a random topic and says it's bullshit for reasons, and the actual... Like, what the topic is almost irrelevant at that point.
Yeah.
So he just falls into patterns about anime dubs or, like, I think last time he was talking about, like, people holding pots on their heads. Like, it's just, like...
Oh, yeah, that was really, really random.
Yeah, he just picks a topic and is like, this is bullshit because reasons, and then people may or may not get mad about it, and I'm probably just doing it for attention anyway.
Yeah.
That's it.
Can we just replace him with Shell? She's not racist, mostly.
It would fit the format of the four windows.
Yeah. Okay, what helmet is this for Volt? It's $6 here, let's go into the arsenal. Appearance.
God damn, the weapon. Helmets. This weapon looks actually really, really nice. I like the highlight that goes up and down it.
Oh yeah. It's the Volt Arrestor helmet, chat. It's one of the Steam Workshop ones, and it is so nice. I really like the other ones, though. The Thalia's one's kind of nice, but it's so big. It feels kind of too big. Not a big... the Relay one's kind of okay, but man, the Arrestor is so good. Storm helmet looks dumb. Okay. You ready to go?
Yeah.
Alright. Stolen Dreams. I actually have never done a salvage mission before, so I'm not really sure what we're doing.
Chat's saying to do void missions. That's literally not an option for me.
We could, but there's no reason to do so.
I physically can't go to that part of the screen, so somebody would have to drag me in.
Yeah, we get keys through random activities. I've got a bunch, but, so you go to the void to get rare resources and parts for the prime weapons. I think I gave you the, prime pistol, the Lex Prime, which is, like, super good, and we should probably get you the Orkin cells for it. It's just... It's kind of boring content, especially because we kind of want to get through the quests.
Yeah, I can see your fire.
Tenno, Maru is the
Weird.
Maybe it's just... Do I just not have it in the display? She'll
guide you. I wonder why I can see your fire.
This is it. Your Lotus has promised me a cut of whatever treasure you find, so don't you tin suits go messing this one up. Get to the void portal.
Maru, I said if there is any treasure.
Oh, come on. The Orican were all about treasure, weren't they? The only question is, how much?
Not a clue. Here, where are you? You've already left.
Yeah, just walking forward. What are you doing?
I was messing with my settings to see if I could see your fire.
Oh.
Hi.
Yeah, I was just listening to them talk and then moving forward. The world was that. It's like a weird plant creature.
Oh, yeah, that's, I mean, it's like a...
Oh, it's a manta ray.
Yeah, it's a sand manta ray.
Sand manta ray.
Terrifying, kinda.
More terrifying in... It would definitely be more terrifying in real life.
Yes.
Yeah, whoa, that's a big hole. Like the Sarlacc's grandmother.
You wanna come over here? It's one of those, like, got a combo doors.
Ah, I can hold you ransom forever.
You could. But I mean, why? Alright. Yeah, I've never done a salvage mission before, so I actually don't know what we're doing. Well, see ya. Did you get the speed boost, or were you outside of the range?
Yeah. Yeah, I felt it. I felt it.
So I've got it with the mod that specifically gives me a, gives me AoE damage as I run by enemies. It's very satisfying.
I think that in general, the I always get people saying to use this weapon and get this mission and all this other stuff. I think people underestimate how long everything in this game takes.
Yeah, it takes a while.
Because if they know the game well enough to know what the items are, then they probably played it a lot and they just have access to everything already, and they forget how long it takes to get access to everything in the first place.
I've just kind of latched onto.
It's gonna take a while.
I've just kind of latched onto a group of fans that know what they're doing and know where to go and already have some of the resources to hand to me.
And like they all yell at each other in your Discord chat about which items are better than what items.
Not too much, actually. It's pretty civil. They get more cranky about lore. It's the lore arguments that get stupid. Are you just fighting everything?
Kind of.
Okay. I'll just go finish the mission then.
There's like a whole level here. We're supposed to just ignore it.
I mean, it's kind of one of those where you see these level sets every once in a while that the less you see of it, the longer it has to, like, be cool. By the way, use your speed boost while crouching. It's some kind of special.
Because you just start doing a really fast crouch walk.
Yeah.
Oop, can't go that way.
Oh. But it's like a sabotage mission, but without the... What? That's really weird.
Oh, right, you changed characters, so you don't have the aura anymore.
Alright, Keith, you probably want to just hurry up. This is kind of cool, and I don't want to just do this without you.
Oh god, how far back am I?
Just use your speed boost, man.
I can't always do it because you don't have the aura.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's pretty cheap.
Well, the thing is, you have to stop and kill to get the energy, though.
That's a good point. I don't know.
You don't just get free energy in this game.
Yeah,
this
unfortunately,
place goes on for days.
Unfortunately, the aura does not match Volt's polarity slot, which kind of sucks. More or less means if I put it on, I can wear less mods, unless I want to rebalance things, which I might do anyway. No, I don't want to do that.
Nope, that was not the way to go. Trying to figure out which parts of this level I'm allowed to platform on right now. Here we go.
Oh yeah, you're in there.
Yeah, the cave area is a little. Look at the map and figure it out basically, because your eyes aren't gonna give you any information. It's a freaking huge level to just sprint through.
They're big. This is why I just kind of blitz through it, because it's like, it'll be okay. I didn't want to just do this without you, because it introduces a new tile set. And that would be
really,
kind
you
of...
don't want, you're not going to go do a boss fight without me again?
That happens very occasionally.
Wait, is this a new tile set? We've been here before.
It's sort of. It's the Orc and Derelict, so it's very similar to the Void, which we've already been to. But it's, like, overgrown and gross, and it has infested all over the place. But, yeah. So where are we going? We're going down and in here.
Like, they took the existing location and covered it in spider webs.
Yes. I don't know, I still like it. It's different. It also has some, like, really interesting platformy rooms that have, like, special loot in them and stuff.
Oh, I got 5.0 poison. What will I do?
That shit can kill you, though.
Yep.
Like, you kind of poo-poo the poison, but that's actually probably one of the most lethal things in the game.
I'm just amused by the notification for it.
There it is.
The game will just be like, you have 5.0 poison. I'm like, that's a really weird notation system for poison.
And say hello to treasure.
Is that stacks or something? Like, I genuinely don't know what it's trying to tell me.
Oh, that's distracting.
Just happened.
The machine. It's gone. Tenno, watch out.
I was still able to kill a guy while we were listening to that guy talk. Kind of snuck up on somebody and destroyed them when I couldn't see past the screen.
But there's nothing more for us here. Exit the derelict and head for extraction.
Pretty sure I just used my ultimate on nothing.
Where's my damn treasure? I was told there would be treasure.
I mean, you killed him.
Whatever that was, it wasn't here for our benefit or yours. Only time will tell what we just uncovered.
We go down to this dumb little hole, by the way.
Oh. Yeah, I was just sprinting around in circles.
It's a little bit hard to figure out what's going on. Sometimes, all the time, really. This level gets, kind of murky.
Yeah, okay. The issue's only exasperated if you try to go in fast mode. Ow.
Yeah, that's why I'm not going in fast mode for this one.
That probably was a wall of fire.
Yeah, that one hurts. Fire is the other deadly thing. And rockets.
This reminds me of the, I think it was on Root Tooth podcast, they were talking about, like, the symptoms of death. Like, some dumb list they found, and, like, it said stuff like, head removed, or all burnt up. Like, fire is the other deadly thing. One of the only two deadly things.
Otherwise, you know, they're good. Missing a heart? Nah,
yeah.
Fine.
Arrows are safe. Especially the pointy kind.
Poison. Not a problem. Don't worry about it. How to spot a dead person. Bye.
Level, why? Why have you betrayed me?
Level don't care about
your shit. Run that way.
Have a speed boost. Have fun.
I think I just stacked our speed boost.
I don't know if they stack. Oh, wait, they do stack, but possibly only for you? I don't know. There was an argument about how the speed boost specifically works. And there wasn't anything particularly useful. Yeek.
Going a little too fast for yourself?
It's more just kind of the weird, like, distancing effect gets really, really strange.
Oh, the way the camera pulls back, like you're playing a racing game.
I do, but it gets really weird feeling.
What?
What?
That sentence was, I do, but it gets really weird feeling.
No, I like it, but, like, it feels weird. Like, okay. It's... a neat visual effect, but, like, it
yeah,
feels
just,
weird
just
to look at.
That's not the sentence that came out the first time, so I was like, what are you saying?
Man, whoa.
Hey, I maxed out my vault.
Orc and Catalyst blueprint. That's good.
The vault maxed out.
Yeah.
It happened. I got the Aether Daggers blueprint.
I think that's what Shell has. Like, I think that's just a generic thing you can get from the market, sadly.
So you're saying there was no treasure? No cure for cloning syndrome? No lost...
Ooh, melee crit damage.
Ordo, there was nothing.
That really is a shame, Maru. I'm sorry.
Nah, I'm used to it. When you don't run with any of the major factions or syndicates, the big paydays are few and far between. I'll manage. Listen, I can't say it hasn't been fun, but with the arcane codices gone, I think it's safe for me to venture back out into the wild. See ya, tin suits.
Alright, well, that's it for Stolen Dreams.
Why do those robots have butt nubs?
That's just straight up turds.
I mean, it actually just looks like a penis with balls.
Yeah, it does.
But where their butt goes.
Well, I mean, they're clones. They could be backwards.
So, like, it got twisted around?
I mean, they're sterile, so yeah, why not?
They shit on their balls every day.
Yeah, the reason why they can't mate is because
that's why they're so angry, because they shit on their balls.
They got ass dicks, and nobody wants to breed with an ass dick.
Ew.
It's super gross. I mean, look. It's a pretty bad way to live.
We'll just have to kill them all just so we can feel better about ourselves.
That's easy enough. I actually don't know how to trigger the next quest.
Do you remember the old war?
Oh, right, that's stance only. Whoops.
Seems to have misplaced those memories.
Oh, yeah, I can't really fit anything into a 3 slot.
Let's see what the list on quests is. We got Arcwing, Howl of the Kubro. Wait, I downloaded something. Somebody had an image on a progression path for this game, and it was actually really solid. Now I gotta go find it.